Father, in Jesus' name, everlasting Father, we give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adorations. We thank you because you are wonderful to us. We give you all power because we know all power belongs to you. We know all glory belongs to you. We know all honor belongs to you. We give you all glory. We say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. Milada prande sikia padashi ala pakua sandaba. Menda da cruci india patoski ada pada basikianda tahila. Ila prata ata crucindia paroti esekelia. Menda robesiti aka paramandusi imba kaponza. Metaria pakusi kibraba libra tisi anda pa. Marabado bianda sikitunia satia kapa. Likratosi imbra da paria masundia ka. Wika pari kapasinda paria kapusi andiba. Mama namra donsi amba kuaka shindi krasuti amba laba. Everlasting Father, we say thank you, Jesus, for everything you have done for us. Be thou glorified in Jesus' name. Our God, we want to go into your word. Your word today, we want to learn more today. We want to hear more from your throne, from the throne of heaven. From the throne of heaven, we want to hear more. Father, speak to us this morning in Jesus' name. Let your power come down upon us in Jesus' name. Let your glory come down upon us in Jesus' name. Set us free from the powers of hell in Jesus' name. Break every barriers of darkness in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. By the special grace of God, this is Heaven and Air Life Program. The person talking to you is Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria, Akure, Ondo State. This Heaven and Air Life Program, which used to do 9 a.m. to 10 or 11 a.m. every morning. And we used to also do Deliverance Hour, which we used to do by 9 p.m. to 10 or 11 p.m. It's either we use 1 hour or 2 hours. It's as God lead us. Also, we used to do our service, Sabbath service, Sabbath service, Sabbath service on the Saturday. We used to do our worship service on Saturday by 10 a.m. to 12 or 1 or 2 a.m. as God also lead us. Also, if you know that you need deliverance, or you need a prayer, or you need a deliverance in your sin, maybe you used to masturbate, you used to angry, you used to fornicate, you used to angry, you know, you meant several things like that, or you want God to set you free from covenant of the darkness, or you want God to set you free from marital problem, or you want God to set you free from a family problem, or there's a demon tormenting your life, come into Deliverance Hour, which we used to do by 9 p.m. every day. That one is daily. But Heaven and Air is just Monday to Saturday. We don't used to do it on Sunday. So Heaven and Air, which we used to do by 9 a.m., what did God say concerning sport? Those who are in sport, what is their destiny? Okay, people who are not in sport, but they used to play games, what is their destiny? Then I will go deep today by the special grace of God. Hallelujah. Is sport in the Bible? Is sport in the Bible? If I will go through it, you will go through it. We talk about it. This is a message you must hear. It's a message you must hear. For no reasons. Never go. Listen to this. It's very important. We are going to talk about 14 sports. 14 games, 14 games that Christians should not do at all. 14 games, sport, that Christians should not try to do at all. 14 games. The Lord bless you as you are listening in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are also going to talk about what the Bible says concerning sport. Open your Bible to 1 Corinthians chapter 9. 1 Corinthians chapter 9. Verses 24 to 27. Listen very well. I will read. Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receive the prize? So run, that ye may obtain. 25. And every man that strive for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown. A corruptible crown. But we are an incorruptible. 26. I therefore so run, not as or certainly, but fight I, not as one that beateth the air. But 27, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a cast away. I will read another version of the Bible. I'm still reading 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24 to 7. That's, I'm still reading that. Surely you know that many runners take part in a race, but only one of them wins the prize. Run then in such a way as to win the prize. Every athlete, you see that, is training. Every athlete in training submit to strict discipline in order to be crowned with a wreath that will not last. You see that? A wreath that will not last. But we do it for one that will last forever. That is why I run straight for the finish line. That is why I am like a boxer who does not waste his punch. I am like a boxer who does not waste his punch. I add in my body with blows and bring it under complete control to keep myself from being disqualified after having called order to the contest. Did God allow a Christian to be doing sport? Why is sport in existence at the first place? What is the meaning of sport? This is a great mystery that many pastors have even not spoken about it. I know this message is going to be a hard message anyway, but I have no choice but to tell you the truth. That's the only place in the Bible that the Bible spoke about sport, running. We have boxing. But listen to me. If you look at that verse when Paul was talking, he said, they all trained themselves to collect a prize, a crown that is corruptible, that is in vain. Some Bible verses say that it's in vain, that is useless. I told you when I get to heaven, Jesus Christ talked to me about football. Everybody need to hear this. And he told me why. And he told me why football should not be played by any Christian. And God told me about games, that games should not be played. Let me tell you, if you personally look at all the sports, you will see that most of them have no meaning. Most of them have no sense. As a Christian, I am not yet talking about what Satan has planned, you know, the intent, what Satan has created. I'm not talking about that. But if you personally look at it, if you sit down and you enter and you start looking from the scripture, from this deep inside this, the spirit, you will see that sport, the thing they are doing there is meaningless. It's just a game of entertainment, a game of pleasure, not a sensitive thing. It's not building to your spiritual life. It's not building to your spiritual life. It's not adding to your spiritual things. It's not creating an atmosphere whereby you can make heaven. It's just working in the flesh. It's a promoter of flesh, a promoter of the body, a promoter of flesh. A promoter of flesh. No wonder Jesus was shouting to my ear that I should warn the Christian that they should by no means play games at all. Hallelujah. God repeated it to my ear. I want you to listen to me very well. He said, all games should not be played. All games. All games. Because every game, let me tell you the truth. I told you that you have not heard my testimony about my encounter with the devil in second heaven. Go and try and watch it. Watch it. Look for it and watch it. Every game you see has a demon attached to it. And that demon captures the heart of Christians who are playing or doing the games. I know very well that many Christians are into games. Many Muslims are into games. Many Abbalists, many idol worshippers are into games. But the fact needs to be said. What is the sense of God concerning games? Games, football, sport, and other things. If you look at where the scripture says about the sport, you will see that it was saying that they were training themselves. They were putting their body on that street punishment, training, just because of a crown that will never last. A corruptible crown. A crown that will be in vain. Please listen to me very well. A crown that will be in vain. a crown that we that will not take you to heaven. A spot that will not take you to heaven. If you personally look at it, please, what is there in slapping each other? There was a spot, a game, whereby you slap each other, you slap your face. Is it meaningless? Is it a meaning something? What does slapping face have to do with heaven? What does it have to do with accessible to something? When the Bible says you should not fight or strive, you are saying that you want to go and start slapping each other so that you can win money. Sport is a game whereby it is attached with mammon. Everybody are into game because of money. They want to have money in life. They want to be a star. They want to be famous. My dear brother and sister, my word, the word I'm preaching, the word of God I'm preaching, it might be somewhere street. But if you don't believe me, you can continue. And let's meet in heaven if you are going to make heaven at last. All sports are created just because you have, they just to sit down and have entertainment. Entertainment. What is the meaning of it? In the olden days, there are games whereby they will bring lions and they will give you a spear, asking you to kill. If you can kill the lion, they will give you money. Is it what is the meaning of it? It's meaningless. And everybody will sit down and they will pay for their seat to just wash you. By the time you start fighting with that lion, the lion will be the lion, they eventually kill you. They will say, hey, there we go. What does it mean? It is a meaningless thing, it's taking people to hell. Sport is a devilish work. It's an idea from the pit of hell. It's an idea from the pit of hell. Nevertheless, exercise is good for the body. I'm not against exercise. And the Bible is not against exercise. You can exercise your body. It's very good for your health, but not sport. If I'm telling you now, by the special grace of God, I've been having a encounter with Jesus Christ when I was 7 years old. I have been 7 years old. I've been having encounters with Jesus Christ, face to face, one-on-one, physically. If I'm telling you things, by the time I grew up and I want to start the ministry, Jesus appeared to me again physically and he touched my tongue and said, everything you say will come out from my mouth because I will speak through your mouth. And since that day, anything I say has been from the Lord by the grace of God. I am telling you now, not my word. Any Christian in sport will never make heaven. You can't make heaven. Any Christian in sport, I have done sport before when I was this small. And in one way or the other, the Lord bring me out of it. Any Christian doing sport cannot make heaven. Cannot make heaven. Nevertheless, there are sports that is good. For example, if you know you want to swimming. If I want to swim in my house, I can dig something in my house and just make a swimming pool in the house I build myself. And if I want to swim, I and my wife can swim. I know it is between me and my wife. Eh? It is between me and my wife. I swim at my house and I go. Nobody is seeing my nakedness. For example, I am not around. No man is around. My wife, for example, I'm just using this as an example. I have my swimming pool in my house. My wife and I are sister friends. They simply go and swim. They swim and they begin to play in the water, play in the water like that. No sin in that one. They were all girls. They were all women. What when they are swimming, it is compound. Nobody seen them, no male seen them. They were all females. Sorry, females, they were all girls seeing themselves. If I want to go and swim in my house, I can dig a swimming pool in my house, and I and my pastor's friend, I say, okay, man of God, let's go and swim. Let's go and swim. No, my wife must not be there. Their wife must not be there to see my laps, my sex, my body. Huh? Male of death, we all swim in the swimming pool. We swim and swim and swim, and we are done. We came out together. We laugh together. We do everything. That one is not sinful. Only swimming pool. For example, I am in my house. I'm trying to put an explanation to this. I'm in my house. I have basketball in my house. I say, man of God, let's play my basketball. We are male. We wear trousers. That one is not sinful. Now, my wife said she wanted to play basketball, and she did not wear trousers. She wears skirt. She wears skirt. A fellow sister wears skirt, and they begin to play basketball in the only way. I say, let us do exercise today. That one is not sinful. They are not doing it for money. Listen to me. They are not betting. They are not doing it for money. They are not doing it to get fame of the world fame. They are doing it just to say, I want to exercise our body. We want to feel good. We want to feel our friendship in Christ. That one is, I'm not talking about that one. But I'm talking about a sport whereby you go because of money. You wear trousers. You wear trousers. If you look at Paul, you will see that. Wait, I want to ask you, listen, what is the meaning of wrestling? Tell me. Wrestling. I begin to beat you, I begin to beat me. I will start showing power. You yourself sit down, and is it godly? Is it godly? I begin to beat you, and you begin to beat me. Eh? Is it godly? Is it godly? Now, I say I'm a boxer. I begin to train to beat you, to blow your face. Is it making sense? As a Christian, is it making sense? No, reason now. Reason. I begin to hold boxer. I begin to train for power. I begin to make my body everything. I begin to train for boxing. I now came to my boss, my fellow human being, just because people want to watch me beat him. Not meaning. It's senseless. It's foolishness. Foolishness. Rubbish. Stupidity. Madness. I begin to blow I begin to train for my strength. And I come to myself, I see my body, I begin to, give him blow. I begin to give blow to my fellow brother. And people were there, hey, Peter, blow him well. Yeah, Peter, is it making sense? It's senseless, it's stupidity, foolishness, madness, it's madness. You are fool. You are walking in foolishness. Your brain does not work. Are you Christian? You sit down there and you watch them. Hey, meaningless. Foolishness. These are all trap from a pit of hell. What does it mean for me to start training for karate? Karate. Karate. What is karate? Eh? What is karate? I'm going to show you. Kia! Kia! And then I'll bring you. Then Mr. Governor, the president of the nation, they will also sit down in their office to watch you fighting. Mr. President of all nations, I don't care anybody can come and arrest me. Sometimes
I don't know. Many leaders will have sexness. What is the meaning of sport? Say that we want to exercise our body. We are not saying you should not exercise your body. Is it compulsory you beat yourself? Must you beat yourself to get money? Imagine me as a pastor. I now went to the sport. I begin to train for boxing. After I trained for boxing, I came back again. And you, my members, you say, hey, see, I post you Peter Daniel. And I begin to do this. I beat somebody down. Say, I post you. Is it, no, not Joseph, is it making sense? No, is it making sense? You, is it making sense? You yourself, Dodge. And I will come back and said, hear the word of God, fighting is a sin. What am I doing? I'm joking. The person I'm blowing the face, and the face come like this. And the eyes come out. All is six. I blow the mouth to the extent that the six come out. A blood begin to run out of the body. And everybody was ailing me because I blow somebody's face. Do you know that blood even cries? When blood comes down of a human being and touch the ground, it used to cry out to heaven. Do you even know that? Wait, what do you think that happened to the blood of Abel? Cain killed Abel. He buried him that nobody will see him. But that blood cried for vengeance. The Bible said the blood of Abel cried for vengeance. Blood. You see, blood is life. For no reason, you should have no reason to shed a blood down. And you will not go and start beating somebody, blowing somebody. One of a very good sport is for you to run. But running takes you to wear trousers. I know this message will be, many people will contradict me. Many people will say, no. I don't care whatsoever people will say no to it. No problem. You can say no to it. But the message of God must be preached to all nations so that when you die, you will not say, Apostle did not tell me. You will not say it. You will not say, Apostle did not tell me. You will not say, Apostle did not tell me. You will not see Apostle did not tell me. Any sport that involves you fighting is a devilish sport. Any sport that involves you fighting is a devilish sport. Any sport at all that involves you blowing each other, beating each other, creeping each other. They call something, I don't even know what they are calling it. They will be using something like this, blowing each other. They will beat themselves seriously. Yeah? They will beat themselves seriously. Any sport that involves you wearing trousers, don't do it. They are devilish. When the Bible says you should not use what belongeth unto man,
Trousers is for man. You have no right. You have no reason to wear trousers. The highest you can wear is skirt. Anything that have one mouth, one face is for women. And anything that have two mouths like this is for man. Except if you are wearing pants. And the pint I'm talking about is not short liquor. Some will say, it will be short liquor, it's also pint. It's not pint. Pint. Only pint. Any sport that involves you, like handball, swimming, volleyball, basketball, cyclings, badminton, fencing sport, all these don't do it at all. They are not good spiritually. Weight lifter. Abeg, what is the meaning of me carrying weight? What is the meaning? Does it add to your spiritual life? Carrying weight. You carry it again. What does it do? What does it do for your spiritual life? Did it increase you for any reasons? Did your spiritual life grow? No reasons. Many of these sports are devilish. Let me say, sports are not good. Except if there is a sport where you know it's good for your health and they are not wearing trousers. You are not wearing trousers. It is not affecting, it's only good for your health. You can do it. But anything that you do for your body, use your body to do. Just because of money, it's not good at all for the spiritual life. So I advise you all to come against sport. Sport is a devilish thing and should not be practiced in the Christendom at all. Please, what is the meaning of taekwondo? Judo, taekwondo, karate, Chinese fight. I come to my YouTube now. As I came to my YouTube, and I saw these karate people. They begin to jump. Why? They fall from air, from up, and they fall down like that. They stand again. They begin to And I look at it. I shook my head. What is the meaning of this? You are training yourself to beat your friend. You are training yourself to be a fighter. If people can use all their determinations, their discipline, and they bring it into Christendom, I'm telling you, many soon will enter heaven. If all the coaches can break all their zeal, All the determination they have in training in sport, and they bring it in holiness and in discipling the people to make heaven. Many souls will have entered heaven. But rather, they are training people to collect a crab that will never last. I watched a gymnastic. A sister was doing a gymnastic as he was trying to, he was trying to jump. He jumped, and he oversomersault. And all his head, his intestine, his body, the gut pieces completely. And the lady died. He died there. He died opening his eyes like this. He completely destroyed. What is the meaning of that spot? Do you think that that lady will be in heaven? Did God send her to be doing sport? Who tell her to be doing sport? Many people have died on the boxing stage, where a neighbor, his fellow brother, knocked him, and he died there. Many wrestlers have died on the stage. Many footballers have died on the stage. What is the meaning of you playing football? Ball, just a ball. A ball. Eh? A rubber, a ball. A leather. You play it, you play, you play it, you show ski. And, and people are playing. Oh my God. It is a painful something. And people are paying a lot of money. Some are paying $100, $200, just to sit down and watch football. Ah. And the work of God is there, suffering. If they ask them to pay for the work of God, they will say this pastor is preaching about money. Ah. If the pastor says help the work of God, they will say he's asking for money. But football can take money from there. To what sport can take money from there? Ah, God is painful, I'm telling you. You cannot help a man of God who is preaching holiness to make him rise to a top whereby he will be able to be speaking to the whole world. But you can pay your money to watch nonsense, devilish things. You will pay your money to watch them. Why? And pastors who are preaching holiness, fasting and praying that you can enter an eternal life, they are suffering. Even to eat sometimes is hard. It's hard for them to eat something. It's hard. It's hard for them to eat. And you are there, you have your money, you go and use it to play first, watch football, play football, sit down on a feed, sit down on a platform to watch football. And you say God will be happy with you. God cannot be happy with you. Sport should not be done. I repeat, sport is a satanic thing. Don't do it at all. Encourage people to live there. They are not profitable for the spiritual life. They are not going to make you enter heaven. Anything that will not take you to heaven, don't do it. Anything that will not prepare you for rapture, don't do it. Anything that will not prepare you to meet Jesus Christ, don't do it. They are all working for flesh. They are all wrestling and working for flesh. And they are not profitable for the spirit. Anything that is not profitable for the spirit is in vain. And it is corruptible. You will not have crown on it. Anything that will involve you to collect money, sports that will involve you to just because of money, you are training yourself, beating yourself down, carrying weight, want to become a famous person. It's not things you can do. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I will not say more than this. In this short sermon, I believe you have gotten your own things there. And I believe this short sermon have done a great thing in your life. I believe this short sermon will by no means take you to heaven. It will take you to heaven. There's no way you can do it. If you can obey it, it will take you to heaven. God bless you, Jesus. The person speaking to you is Apostle Peter Daniel from Nigeria. By the special grace of God, I'm he that God have encountered with several times, starting from when I was 7 years old, where he came to me physically to meet me one-on-one physically. He came to me daily to speak to me. If you want to support the ministry, if you are watching us and you want to support the ministry, kindly do WhatsApp me. My number will be placed there on the YouTube, will be placed there. WhatsApp me, call me. If you have any question, call me. If you want to pay your tithe or offering, call me. If you want to be among the partnership group, we have partnership group who we used to pray for, interceding for, to be supporting this ministry. We want to be supporting this ministry. Supporting this ministry. Probably every week or every 2 weeks or every month, just to make sure that we are able to promote the work of the ministry, go to the radio, go to the other play platform, TV channel, and preach the gospel to them. That's why this platform for a partnership is all about. To sponsor the gospel, to go forward. So that we can also be announcing and be prophesying in the newspaper, telling the people about heaven, preparing the answers. If you want to be supporting us, be in partnership where we used to have a serious prayer for them, you can also WhatsApp me or call me. My number is +234 81 389 66 287. This is Heaven and Air Life Program. I pray you shall be blessed. Continue to be uplifted in Jesus' name. You and I will not end up in hell in Jesus' name. Let me pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, our everlasting Father, we give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adorations. We thank you because you are almighty. We give you the glory today. We thank you for this short message, which has gone round in the life of people. We ask you that you give us the grace to obey, the power to follow it in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, we pray that as we are going now, you give us the grace to prepare to wait on you to make heaven in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen, 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 in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Bye.